In this video, we'll learn how to use touch shortcuts in Adobe Fresco. These give us a really nice intuitive way to quickly and easily modify the behavior of many of the most important tools in Fresco. Let's go ahead and try out some brush shortcuts. So you can see I've got my blue layer active here. Under my pixel brush, I've selected the gunky inker brush, and that's under the ink submenu. So I've got a pretty large diameter here, and you can see I can just draw and brush out this nice textured brush stroke. Maybe I feel like after adding those additional marks, I'd like to actually go back and erase some of that. So let's go ahead and switch to the eraser tool. And you can see as I'm erasing, I'm getting this very crisp edge that looks a lot different than the texture that I see over here. So let's go ahead and undo that and try a brush shortcut. So let's go ahead and activate the touch shortcut. And now when I brush over that area, I'm switching my pixel brush from a laying down color mode to an erasing mode. And you can see I get to maintain that really nice texture while still taking away from my brush strokes. Let's move on to this orange layer and use that to explore some of the touch shortcuts we can use when making transformations. So I'll go ahead and activate the transform tool. And you can see we get a dialog here where I can do things like scale and rotate. When we use the touch shortcut while rotating, Fresco is going to snap to 15 degree increments. So that makes it really nice if we'd like to rotate perfectly 90 degrees or perfectly 180 degrees, we're going to be snapping right to those locations. Now in this transform, we can also tap and drag and move around whatever we're transforming. And again, sometimes we want a little bit more precision when we're doing that. So the touch shortcut is great because it's going to constrain our movement either horizontally or vertically. So that makes it really easy to move something just straight up without moving it left and right, or just side to side without moving it up or down. Let's go ahead and cancel out of that transformation for now. Another place that touch shortcuts come in really handy is with the Liquify tool. So let's go ahead and switch to this checkerboard layer. And Liquify tool's a little bit buried in the toolbar menu. We're gonna click on the transform tool and then click on the Liquify icon. So this lets us do all sorts of really interesting warping and sort of organic changes to a layer. You can see lots of variations here. I'm just gonna stick on the regular Liquify tool. And I've got a pretty big brush here. Let's go ahead and maybe dial that down just a little bit. So you should be able to see now, I can click and drag and warp my original image, almost like it's liquid. Now you can see here, I've really warped this quite a bit. Of course I can undo, go back to the original, but maybe I'd actually like something in between where I'm liquefying just some parts of this layer and maybe keeping others closer to the original. So let's redo that liquefy and activate the touch shortcut. So this is going to switch our liquefy tool from liquefication mode to a reconstruct mode. So it's kind of going to give us a way to really precisely unliquefy parts of our image. So you can see here, it's returning to its original grid alignment. And I could keep going there. You can see that a little bit more clearly, how it is reconstructing the original orientation of the layer. Now, overall, I'm not really liking this effect, so let's cancel out of this and go back to square. So hopefully you're getting an idea of how useful the touch shortcut is. Up until now, we've only been using primary touch shortcuts, but the touch shortcut actually gives us another set of options for many of the tools that we covered. And I'll show you what I mean. So the primary touch shortcut happens when we touch the center of the touch shortcut circle. And notice when I do that, I get a larger concentric circle around the touch shortcut. So I can actually take my pointer or my finger and move it into that outer circle, and that gives us a secondary touch shortcut. So you can kind of think of it a little bit like a left mouse button and a right mouse button. So let's see how those primary and secondary touch shortcuts work with some vector art. So these red lines here are actually vector lines. I want to make sure I select this layer that's holding my vector art. And I can tell that by looking at the icon to the left of the layer. And I also want to be using my vector brush. So you can see here I could add additional vector lines. I'll go ahead and undo that. Maybe what I'd like to do is focus on these corners here and make them sharper where the lines are overlapping. I could try to erase these parts of the overlapping lines using the primary touch shortcut. So you can see there I'm erasing, and it looks okay, but it's a little bit tedious, and I can see I'm sort of eating into that line there, which I don't actually want. So let's undo that. So let's try again to manage those overlaps with a secondary touch shortcut. So I'm going to tap and hold on that touch shortcut and just move my finger out to that outer concentric circle. You can see the inner one goes away. And now I'm using a secondary touch shortcut. So this is going to behave differently than the primary one, and it's going to use the overlaps of those vector lines to simply make a cut point. So I just need to stroke over the part of the vector line that I want to erase, and it's going to give me that really nice angular transition that I'm going for. We've only covered the most fundamental touch shortcuts in this video, and you can see a list of all of the primary and secondary touch shortcuts under the question mark in the title bar by clicking on Touch Shortcut. So this gives a really nice illustrated list of all of the primary and secondary touch shortcuts that we didn't get a chance to cover here. All right, so that's a quick overview of how to use touch shortcuts in Adobe Fresco.